Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate, Enhanced Edition, Blind.
Sure.
Oh, this guy is still up in the middle of the night like this. I think it's here that we need to go to hand him in the sea chart. Mendas, I believe his name is. And then we might go on a little voyage. Here's Callahan. I don't think we need to talk to him. Mendas!
Alright. I have waited long for such as you.
Wonderful, my friends. I copy charts now. If you are ready, I hire a boat for your journey. Here is the money I owe you. 2,000 gold. I am ready. Where's your boat? I hire a boat at the docks here in Olsgoth's Beard. I meet you there soon. We have agreed to travel the trackless sea for Mendas and fetch him the logbook from Balduran's final voyage. Mendas will hire a boat and meet us at the docks in Olgoth's Beard. Exciting. This is Sword Coast content, in case anyone didn't know. Olgoth boy.
Why me?
I must be speaking to you.
Okay.
Listen, please.
I think the boy is in your way. There he goes. All is ready, friends. I pay for a boat, and I give copy of sea charts to you. Alright, so you took it, now you're giving it back. I have bought boat to use. It has food and water for journey. Everything is ready. You go now? Let us leave immediately. Most excellent heroes, may gods grant you speedy journey. I will await your return at my house here in Olgoth's Beard. Go well.
Your ship sets its sails against the morning light, and you're off across the waves. The Sea of Swords allows your passage without incident, and in a scant amount of time, you're on to truly open waters. A score or more of days pass, but the aptly named Trackless Sea seems to stretch before you without end. The waters are calm, though the wind remains steady and sure. The merchant vessel your employer has chartered is a fine ship, but her crew is not accustomed to journeys so far off the established trade routes. The more superstitious among them speak of a great waterfall off the edge of Faerûn, of a secret elven nation that scuttles all that dare come near, or even of island-sized turtles that eat whole ships. Such fancy weighs heavily on the minds of nervous sailors, and the mood aboard ship slowly turns. Tensions begin to mount, and rumors of mutiny threaten your resolve. It is a mixed blessing that all aboard are soon given a very real danger to occupy their thoughts. The storm comes without warning and hits with a fury that seems almost deliberate. Gale force winds toss the ship about like a cork, and it is all the crew can do to keep her afloat. Their efforts, though valiant, are ultimately futile. And when the main mast splinters, you know the ship is lost. As the hull gives way, there is a glimpse of something in the distance, a steady illumination against the black of night. Grasping debris for flotation, you abandon the wreck and begin to swim under the heavy burden of your equipment. You head towards the glow, hoping it is not a sea wisp or some other nefarious trick of the eyes. You awake the next morning with a mouthful of sand. You are waterlogged, exhausted, and you have an aching pain that lets you know you are very much alive. The ship is so much kindling. There is no sign of the crew, but there do appear to be footprints in the sand.
Well, scratch one boat. Okay. Someone named Soliana here.
Why me?
I guess that's the remains of our boat. Greetings? The little girl?
You are new. You smell different.
Or funny. You swim in? Yes, child, I did swim in. Our ship sank, and we are in need of shelter. Okay, I believe you. Not see many that swim in. Many float, but don't wake up. Fishies are mean, and cliffs hurt ship homes. You lucky. Still smell funny, though. Maybe you stay and belong? Well, they probably smell like seaweed and salt water. Many float, but don't wake up. Stay and take over. Belong to whom, little one? You are not alone here? Alone? Of course not, silly. There's Mame, Pape, my brother, too. We've got neighbors, too. The village is very nice. It's boring sometimes, but I like it. The seas are treacherous in this area. How did you come to live here? I saw no ships nearby. Mame says great-great-grammy came here on a ship home like you. Something happened and they had to swim or be caught by the fishies. The ship home is here somewhere, I guess. We're not allowed to go there. So ask her some more questions. I grow weary of your voice. You do not seem alarmed to see me. How often do strangers come here? Not very often, and they don't always want to make friends. That's what Mame says, but I never seen anyone that doesn't belong, until I meet you anyway. You still smell funny, but you not scary. Not like the beasties. The beasties? What do you mean? The beasties are scary. They sometimes look like us, but they change and get mean. More doppelgangers? Mame says there are nothing more than animals, but the other animals don't hate us so much. Maybe you will help us? Perhaps, but I should meet with your people and find out what is going on first. Yeah, you go to the village and speak to Mame's friend, Kaishas. She leads while Mr. Chieftain is away. Don't know where he went, but he's away, and you should speak to Kaishas. I gotta go, but maybe we'll see each other later. Maybe I'm too busy playing. We'll see. Bye-bye. There must be a settlement on this island because I met a child far too young to have gotten here on her own. Indeed. You better now? I have to go soon. I would like to speak more with you. How did you come to live here? Okay. She said that before. Alright. Well, we're on the southernmost area. I'm just trying to fill out the fog of war stuff. Okay, there's a bridge over waters here. Is this the village? Could be. I've got some huts. Almost look like towers. Hello? There's nobody in here? Like a storehouse.
Why me?
A potion of healing. Oddly murky. Yeah, I don't trust these. Potion of explosions. This potion is a vial of pain, as it will explode into a burning ball of fire upon impact. Keep it in a safe place, lest you meet an untimely end. Is that the same kind of like we have? Maybe Imuwin can throw that. Here's the sea charts again. Copy he gave, Mendas gave us. Unless he put it in his copier and just made it up. Potion gaze. Oh, he probably manually copied it. Oil of fiery burning. So this is the other one. This can be hurled to around 40 feet. 5d6. As opposed to the potion of explosions. 6d6. Doesn't say how long we can throw it. Not like the other one. I don't know if I have use of that, but since she has one, might as well give her the other one. And then we have this here, which is empty.
Sure.
Well, there's someone here. Hello.
Some will not trust you. Some like me.
Must be more shipwrecked sailors. Please go and speak with Kaishas Gan. Oh, you? Are you trying to leave? You can go. Don't let us stand
what?
In your way.
Fine.
No, he's not leaving. We can't take this stuff.
I don't. All right.
We can't take that stuff without him seeing.
Sure.
Another commoner.
Some will not trust you. Some like me.
Okay. That's what you guys say around here. Maybe Kaishas Gan is in here. Or not.
Why me?
But it would appear in here, at least we are alone. Oh, Imuwin.
Yep. Hey, how are things going?
Well, first, detect traps. Okay. Okay. Two pearls. A potion of fire giant strength. That's what gives you strength 22. And a potion of regeneration. Okay, this doesn't... These don't say they have murky... quality to it. Empty. How dare you? Alright, three potions of healing. It's a fire giant. I guess we'll get to Minsk. We have three here. What is this? Regeneration? 3 potions of healing. Well, I'll take these. Oh, really? I forget to restock him there? Well, you know where these are going then. Seventeen potions of heroism. We still have 3 of these extra healings. So he's got an 8. Okay. Just making sure we all have stuff. I didn't realize he was so low on potions. Alright. Good thing we got a few more. Oh. I keep doing that.
Go pesta! Sure!
No pesta. No pesta someone else. Alright, so...
Alright!
Where does this go? I don't know where this village is. Probably up more to the north, but I kind of feel like seeing what's over here. And there's not much. We can walk on the water, though. But not here. Alright. So we've covered the entire southern area of the isle. There's this bridge across here. There's 2 of them. More commoners. They all say the same thing.
Some will not trust you.
Yep.
Some like me.
That is nice for you. Who's that? Evolt. Evolt. I would speak with Evolt.
I smell... outsider?
Outsiders? Humph. You should speak with head woman rather than wander about. The villagers here all suggest I talk to their head woman before wandering about, yet none of them tell me where she is. Though I'm pretty safe in assuming she's not in here, but there may be some vital supplies inside. We're alone, I take it?
Yeah. Sure.
Empty. And empty. Okay.
All right.
I am actually wandering about looking for head woman.
I say my mind. Go as soon as you can.
Okay, I will. We have a little farthing here.
I lost my dolly.
You sure are big. Does Kaishas know that you're here? You should go and see her. Yeah, but I don't know where that would be. I'm guessing... let's try over this way. Perhaps here. More boats. Alright.
Yeah, mate?
Talun says, from the mainland you be? Never thought I'd see the day. Kaishas will be wanting to see you. Come back and indulge an old man when you be finished with the head woman. Alright.
Good on you if you save the day.
Am I leaving the premises? I want to see what's in there.
Sure.
Do I dare?
They're called?
No, I don't think we should.
Why me?
I was going to try to have Imu and sneak around. And see if we can, she can open one of those undetected, but it's just such a small area. With his back turned, he might not see us, but I don't want to take the chance. How'd you get over there? She got on the mainland from that area. Oh, we're all split up over here. Okay, so I know I went up that way. Alright, there's another hut or whatever over here. Is that a structure as well? Let's go check this out first.
Sure.
Another commoner. Oh. Only he went inside.
Sure.
You are unlike. You do not belong.
Please, I may not speak with you. You must speak with the head woman. Well, I'll try to remember to come back to Talun's.
I need an ale.
Sure. Who wants us to talk again before... Well, after we talk to the head woman. Check down here because we haven't been there. We can walk on the water here. Must be really shallow. Oh, not all the way. Okay. Look at that, though. That would drive me insane. That. All right. So, I did see something that looked like a structure. But if we go down here, we can clear some of this fog of war away, and then we'll head over there. I went in there, right? Yeah. There we go. At least some of it. We'd have to go over here to actually clear it. Really? So, I don't know. It says the child was speaking about people that sometimes look human and sometimes aren't. Makes me think more doppelgangers. But then said they were animals. Which, I don't know, I don't think of doppelgangers as animal. I mean, they speak. So, I'm not sure. I myself do not think of doppelgangers as being animals. But that's just me. Might just be me. Another commoner, looking ready for battle. And the Jorin.
You are stranger to us, stranger than us.
Move along!
You must be the ones whose boat broke up on the reefs. Our head woman, Kaishas Khan, will want to speak with you. Indeed. Oh, is that through here then?
You are from away? Welcome then.
Well, thank you. You're the first person to say anything like that. Another commoner.
I don't know you. You are a stranger.
Another one here. Okay, Kaishas gone. Kaishas gone. Probably in there. Let's go look around here. We can go behind the place. Yeah, with that wall there wasn't much point, but... Alright. Kaishas gone. There's no one in here. Where is this Kaishas gone?
Sure.
Ooh. A secret. Don't tell me Kagan uncovered that.
I don't want to talk.
Secret? It's probably Imowen, even though she was all the way over there. Alright.
Why me?
Wait, what's going on? Locked. Oh, you people get out of each other's way.
Alright, alright.
Huh. Okay.
Go pester someone else.
We need a key for that. Maybe Kaishas gone will give us that.
All right.
Oh, we'll take it from her corpse.
All right.
These kind of look like street signs or something, but maybe not. I don't know what they're supposed to be. Perches for birds or something? So, not in here then, but... Can we? No. Looks like we can walk over there, but no. Alright, so maybe it's on the other side of this wall here. So we just go further this way and up here. People like telling us to go see her, but don't say where she is. So perhaps in here. Commoners.
You are not like we are.
Durlisle?
Well, you are a strange sight.
Who, you? You do not belong. You are none like I have seen. To Kaishas you must go. She leads, and you must ask her will to stay. Others may attack if you do not speak to she. Do come back when you have. I wish to speak. Okay. So what's the other guy's name? Something Ushas or something? He also... Okay, a woman by the name of Kaishas can smooth my way with the local villagers. Some will attack. Well... I need to know where she is. Is she that way? Wait, this is where we were already. Oh. Okay, is this your farm then? Lal?
You will not taint the village.
Welcome to our humble village. The head woman will want to see you. Gatekeeper. Oh, they got pumpkins. Very seasonal. It is not wise to leave without the permission of the head woman. Okay, we can't leave, and I guess going this way is leaving? Oh, there's a butterfly. Nice. Alright, let's try in here. I don't know if they just all assume we know. I haven't talked to this guy yet. If they all just assume we know where she is? Marily? Cutting us off. Strangers, how is it possible? You must speak with Kaishas. Okay?
You are not like us.
Where is this Kaishas?
I don't know you. You are a stranger.
Yes, I am a stranger. Okay. In either of these, maybe that one. But let's go check in here. Because why not? Hopefully no one attacks us. Ah! Kaishas! Hail! Hail to thee. Let's save. Actually going to talk to Kaishas next episode, guys. Thanks so much for watching. See you in the next episode, and always, seek adventure.